Hi everyone, this is Preeti Anchan and today we shall explore how to work with simple data. We will also see some options in the home tab. So to start with, let me just delete this sheet. A shortcut key to delete a sheet is Alt E L. You'll get a pop-up whether you want to delete it or no. I'll do OK. So I'll just create some sample data here before we explore the further options. So for example, if I want serial numbers over here, I'll write one. This is one way of dragging numbers. So for example, you write 1, 2 or any number for that matter, and then you'll just drag it. Okay. Another way of doing the same thing is you write one number, any one number, even if you've written any number in between, say for example 53, and you want to drag the further numbers, the process is the same. You move the mouse near this box over here. Okay, when the cursor becomes a black plus, press Control, you'll get a double plus sign, and then drag. Whichever way you drag, whether you drag it downwards or right side, however you want it. So for example, I'm creating a small data. Now for example, if I have some month names over here, so if I write months. Now if you've noticed, when you work with month or weeks, weekday or anything, you know, these basic things, you automatically get it. Okay, so if you just drag it, or if you come over here and if you'll double click, you'll get the remaining in a go. Why this happens is because there is something called as custom list in Excel, and these are like default list. We will later on explore how to create a list of your own. So for example, let's say if there are some data which you would frequently use, some regions or some departments which you would be wanting to come in a sequence, you can add it in your custom list once. That basically gets saved in your Excel. So whichever file you open in your system, you will be able to use that list. So we will come to that later on. I'm just creating some dummy data here. I want numeric data, so let me just use a function which will get me numeric data. There is a function called ranbetween. You have to just give a range. So for example, starting range from 1000 to 9000. So this is ideally used when you want dummy data. So you've just randomly got some numbers. Now ideally what happens with this function is whenever you do anything in this sheet, the set of numbers keep changing. So my requirement now is I want to remove these functions. I just want to keep the value. Okay, so I'm going to use a paste special function here. I'll copy this. Shortcut is Control C. For a normal paste, it would be Control V. But us, so I'll press Control Alt V for paste special, and I'll press V or just click on this. What this does is it will just paste the values there itself. Okay, so here we have only the values. In case for any reason, let's say you have some calculation here, and I have written a formula, salary into, I'm just giving some random percentage, into 5%. In case I would just want to copy the formula, you can just drag it. Okay, so now if I have some formulas here, I want to copy these formulas in the next column. I just want the formulas, I don't want the value. So I'll accordingly do formulas. So when I select formulas here, the value won't be pasted, but the formula will be pasted. So basically it will do the previous value into 5%. So let's say this is TA. So this is some basic paste special features. There is another feature in PaySpecial wherein you can convert this vertical data into a horizontal data. Ideally, this is the data in most of the worksheets you would be working on. So when I say horizontal and vertical, vertical data is ideally when you have your headings in the row, and a horizontal data would be when you would have your headings in the column. So for example, if I just copy this, Control C, and let's say if I do a PaySpecial here and transpose it, Control Alt V. Okay, so you click on this transpose option here and do OK. So this is a transpose data. So as I said, if the headings are in the columns, then it's a horizontal data. So you would have heard about VLOOKUP and HLOOKUP. VLOOKUP would ideally work on this data, which is a vertical data, and HLOOKUPs will work in a horizontal data. Again, lookups we will be taking in the further sessions. At the moment, we are doing a very basic session wherein we are understanding how to use some simple day-to-day options. There is another good feature. So for example, I have a set of values here, static values. And if I want to increase this number by 1000, so if it is 522, I would want it to be displayed as 622. Okay, so you just write a value here. For example, I write 1000. I'll copy it. I just copied this cell here. I'll select the static values. This is ideally when you would not want to use a formula, but you just want to, you know, just increase the set of numbers which you have in your sheet. Just a quick way to do it, instead of, you know, writing a formula and then doing a PaySpecial. If it is a simple addition, multiplication, division or subtraction, you can simply do this. It's in the PaySpecial. So I copied over here. I selected this entire list. I'll do Control Alt V again, PaySpecial. And you have to come to this section, operation. For example, I want an addition. So I'm going to do add and do OK. So as I mentioned earlier, I wanted that 522 as 622. So accordingly it is increased. The plus point is it is not really connected to any formula, but it is done what a formula would do. So it's as good as writing a formula and doing a PaySpecial. Similarly, you could do multiplication, division, subtraction. Now in this data, for example, if I have some blank values, okay. Sometimes you download data from somewhere, and if there is blank values, and what happens when you have blank values is it's a bit difficult to navigate because your selection would stop there. So if I'm using my down arrow key, I will not directly go to the end. It will just take me to the last filled cell. So what I want to do is I want to fill all of these blanks with a zero. So I'll select this section, this entire column, and I'll go to special. So like how we've seen PaySpecial, there is this go to special under find and select. You go to find and select, go to special. I just want to select blanks. Okay, so you have various options here. You can select constants. Constants are nothing but numbers, numeric value or text. Anything static is a constant. You can select only formulas. At the moment I want to select blanks. So I selected blank. I'll do OK. So in that selection, in that column selection, whatever cell was blank is selected. I'll just put a value. I wanted 0. So if you notice, my active selection is C4 because that is the first cell and I had started selecting it from upwards. Hence, this is the first selection. Don't click anywhere. Write 0. Type 0 here. Okay. I want the same number to be filled in my other selected cells, my other blank cells. So to fill that automatically, I'll use a shortcut called Control Enter. Okay, when you do that, if you notice, all my blank cells are automatically filled with 0. Okay, so this is a very good feature wherein you want to control all the blanks in your sheet. So for example, you have a huge data and you would have many blank cells in between, and you want to just at once fill the cells so that, you know, you can navigate in your sheet easily, or for any reason, for that purpose, you know, for presentation or whatsoever, you can simply use this blanks option and you can fill values in it. Let me just format this a bit. So these are some basic formatting. I will not really get into formatting, but just to quickly give you let's say I'm selecting some font. This is to go on increasing the font size, bold, underline, italic. These are to give borders. This is the background color and this is the font color. So for example, I've given some font color. Now let's say if I want to put borders for it, we'll explore a bit of borders. These are simple borders, like you can just click on it, you'll understand what are the types of borders. What I would want to show you is how to, you know, give a specific type, like for example dotted type line, or or I want to give a different color. So for example, I selected double dot or this dot. Again, I'll go to this option, I'll select a color, and then I'll do all borders. So whatever line type I took, whatever color I took, it will automatically fill it. At any point in time you want to clear the formatting, you go to this clear option. If you delete, even if you press delete option, it just deletes the data. But in case you want to clear formatting, you can come over here, clear. You either clear the entire data or the formats, or let's say you want to just clear the content. Okay, hyperlinks, comments, ideally formats and clear all is used very frequently. So for example, I want to clear the formats. I'll click on this option here. So all the formatting is gone. It takes us to the default formatting. So the default formatting in Excel is ideally calibre 11. So it's accordingly taking you to that formatting. There is this option over here called Format Painter. Okay, so for example, you just click on it, you do some formatting, you keep that cell selected wherever the formatting is, and you drag the formatting to whichever cell you want. Let's say I want to do this formatting on every alternate cell, but if you notice that Format Painter option is gone. So in case you want to use it at multiple locations, like not in a sequence, but let's say every alternate row or every alternate column or in different sheets, what you should do is to use this option multiple times, double click on Format Painter, okay, and then you can use it multiple times in whichever location you want. And to stop it, you'll press an escape button. Okay, so let me just clear all the formatting. I'll just keep the data. These are some simple alignments. To add a row, I want to add a heading here. Okay, so the shortcut key to select a row is Control Space Bar, and to add a row it's Control Shift Plus. The keypad, then it's just a Control Plus. Okay, so if you're using the icon before the backspace, the button before the backspace, it's Control Shift Plus. Let's say I want to give a heading, something random. So I give some heading and I'll select this entire range. I want it like a heading, so I want it in the center. I'll do merge and center. I do some formatting. So this is like my heading. Whenever you want, you can merge. In case in a cell the text is, you know, exceeded the width, and you want to just fit in this column width, you click on this wrap text. So it will wrap the text. So let's say you want to wrap text as in when you're typing. So let's say I want to say last quarter, and quarter should come in the next line in the same cell. So I'll say last, and I'll press Alt Enter. I'll write quarter, enter. So this is how it will be shown. It's the same thing that we did for wrap text, but as in when you're typing. Okay, so we learned a few shortcut keys in today's session too, as in when we're exploring these home tab. This is some simple formatting. If you quickly want to change the formatting of any selected set of columns or rows or entire data, you can come over here. By default is general formatting, but if you specifically wanted number formatting, give decimals, short date, long date, time, percentage, you can get quick options from here. Again, these are to increase decimals in case there were decimals, to make it percentage. When you click on percentage, ideally it will multiply with 100 and put a percentage symbol. You want it back to general format. We'll be coming to this conditional formatting as a separate topic, because that is important topic and we will take it up in a different session. Show you an autosum feature. So for example, I want to sum over here. I want to do a sum function over here. So you go to this auto sum and it will select all the numbers above that cell and you'll get a sum. Shortcut key to use the auto sum function is alt equal to enter. If you notice, when you go over here, you get the sum. There are some basic features also, like some basic functions. Sum, average, count, max, min. So this is something which one would, you know, very randomly use. So you get it over here. And then you have this fill option. Fill is basically, if I had a formula here, I want to drag this formula, and if let's say my data was huge, so I'll do a control C. I'll go to the previous filled cell. I'll go to the control down, last filled cell. Again, I'll do right arrow. And if I want to drag this formula, I'll select this entire range. Again, control top arrow key. And I'll do control D. Okay. Similarly, I can do control R. So for example, if this was blank, I'll do control. For selection, selecting a entire range, it is control shift selection. Okay, just to move around, it was control arrows. But if you want to select an entire set of rows or columns, it's control shift and arrow. Control shift down, and then I just want one row, one column after this. So shift right. I want to fill all of these formulas towards the right. So I'll do control R. Control R is nothing but fill towards the right. Similarly, you can fill upwards as well as left. So for example, if there was a value here and I want to fill the same value on top, I'll just select it like that and I'll do fill up. So accordingly it will get filled up. Filter, again we will be taking this as a separate topic. We'll quickly just explore the find and replace option. So in case you want to find some text, you can just click on find and you write a text. You want to replace something. So for example, I want to find May. If you just do find, it'll just highlight. If you want to replace, I'll just replace it. Replace all. Okay, there are some more options. If you click on, you know, if you expand this options, now whenever you're finding something, there could be scenarios wherein you do not know which sheet that text is in, but you know there is some text which is, you know, starting with the name June or something. So you can select within workbook, so all the sheets in the workbook would be searched and would be retrieved. You want to go row wise or you want to look into formulas, or you can specify. Usually Excel is not case sensitive, but in case you want to have exactly, like you are unable to find some text and you want to find exactly the same case, you can write it in a particular case. For example, M capital and then the other alphabet small, and then you'll search as match case. So exactly the same case will be found. So for example, if it was June, and for example, if I'm finding May here, and you have May, let me find something else. If I'm finding June and if I say match case, I'll get this cell. But let's say if I write June like this, even though I have the text here, but I'll not be able to find it if I say match text, because it will exactly search for this case. Now this is uppercase, and since there is no uppercase in this month column, it is not going to find. okay, we could not find what you're looking for because you have selected this option. So in case you know there is some text what you're finding, it's there in the sheet and you're not able to find, just expand this options and just see whether you have this options enabled. You also have an option called as match entire cell content. So if that cell is a complete word, then only it has to find, otherwise it will not find. Okay, so these are some of the features that you can use while you're doing a simple find and replace. That was all from the home tab. I've just shown you some important features which you would be using on a day-to-day basis. Thank you so much, guys. In case you have learned any new feature in this session, please let me know in the comment section. Thank you so much.